People always ask me, Alex, why C++ programmer salaries are so low? What is the reason? Considering that C++ is one of the most challenging languages to learn and work with, the job market presents a unique situation where most positions for this language offer salaries significantly below the market average. I believe this is unfair. So why this happened? Well, there are several reasons. First of all, C++ has one of the smallest market shares among modern programming languages. If you look at this report, we'll see that its share is barely under 1%. This means that there are far less job openings for C++ if we compare it to Python or JavaScript. But you might ask, since it's a such complex language, there must be fewer specialists. Actually no. C++ became an academic language a long time ago, entirely replacing Object Pascal. Almost all university graduates know how to code in it, because they probably went through some courses like microcontroller programming, where they also extensively study C++. And here comes its main competitive disadvantage. Most C++ projects are very similar, and the majority of C++ job openings can be filled with any university graduate, essentially a junior developer. Unlike Java or C#, you don't need to master massive frameworks like Spring or .NET to get a job. As a result, every year hundreds of C++ programmers graduate from each university in the country. This creates a significant competition for every available position, and where there's intense competition, salaries drop, because employers can easily find someone willing to work for less money. The third reason is the types of projects where C++ is used. Of course, there is embedded development, driver programming, and rewriting performance-critical components from high-level languages to C++. All of this is very complex and potentially requires deep knowledge of algorithms and unique personal qualities of developer. Frankly, this is one of those cases when you can often tell what language programmer is writing in just by looking at his photo. But C++ is also used in game development. And game dev is one of the most popular fields in IT, which attracts a massive number of students. This abundance of aspiring developers keeps salaries well below the market average since companies can underpay them. However, it's not just about games. Looking at the IT industry in general, which business has the most money? That's right, it's fintech. And what distinctive feature all fintech projects have? A fast delivery cycle to minimize time to develop a client-oriented MVP, something that's nearly impossible with low-level languages like C++. These requirements are met by dynamic languages, with extensive business-oriented frameworks, large libraries of ready plugin solutions, and most importantly, high-level abstraction from computer hardware. This lets engineers to focus on developing business features instead of micromanaging memory and working with registers. As a result, C++ resides in a niche where big money isn't flowing much, and the return on investment on programmers' work is relatively slow. This also affects salaries. Companies willing to pay C++ developers above the market average are rare, and their positions are quickly filled by the best talent, again due to high competition. So, what should junior C++ developers do? If you're entering IT after easy money, you're better off picking a simpler and fun language like Python. But if you enjoy writing in C++ and tinkering with hardware, then who cares how much you pay it if you're doing what you love? Anyway, salaries in C++ haven't fallen down to the level of PHP or HTML, so you won't starve to death. And in 10 years, who knows, you might become a top-tier specialist and land a job in Silicon Valley. And that's it for today. Like and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this.